He's accompanied on the veena by Mrs. Srivita Chandramani. She's a familiar face here too. Before we start, I'd like to thank our sponsors, the Associated Students of the University of Washington, and the Ethnomusicology Program at the University of Washington. Have a nice evening.
ब्रह्मग्रंथिज मारुतानुगतिना चित्तेन हृत्पंकजे सूरेणा मनोरंजक श्रुतिपदं योह्यं स्वयं राजते ब्रह्मग्रंथिज मारुतानुगतिना चित्तेन हृत्पंकजे सूरेणा मनोरंजक श्रुतिपदं योह्यं स्वयं राजते यस्माद्ग्राम विभाग वर्ण रचनालंकार जातिक्रमो वंदे नादतनुं तमुद्दुर जगज्जीतं मुदे शंकरं तिरत्तत्तत्तिरादेतादत्तत्तिरा Friends and elders, I am very happy to be here today, particularly today, because today is the day when the great Nada Jyoti, Nada Yogin, Shri Muthuswami Dikshitar shook off his mortal coil. Naraka Chaturdashi. That was the Deepavali day. Of course, you, all of you have had a very fine, very gala Deepavali. It's too late to wish a Deepavali. Now, I am very much beholden to the organizers of the Speak Meke, the prime pillars of the Speak Meke organization here, to have given me this blessed opportunity to be present before you and speak something, pay my homage, pay homage to the great composer, Shri Muthuswami Dikshitar. He lived from 1775 to 1835. He was born in the month of Palguna Kritika. Palguna Nella Kritika Nakshatra. Shyama Sastri too was born on Kritika Nakshatra. Tyagaraja was born on Chitrastha. These three, Shyama Sastri born in 1762, Jagaraja in 1767, and Muthuswami Dikshitar, the youngest of the Trinity, born in 1775, they constitute the Trinity, musical Trinity. The classical music of the present day is very much the effort of them, fruit of the efforts of the three master composers known as the musical Trinity. But I may tell you there have been so many Trinities and so many Panchamurtis in different walks of aspects of musical lore, musical output. Now today, I am going to present a few salient aspects of the Dikshitar's contribution, multi-dimensional contribution. He was not merely Kriti composer. He has composed, of course, just one sample of a Chaukavarna. Kritis of varying formats. And the Dikshitar family was noted for its erudition. And that too, the composite known as what is known as Ragamalika. While singing the different items, representative items, I will explain the features of Dikshitar's Kritis. I will put the horse before the cart, not the cart before the horse. Now, Muthuswami Dikshitar, he resurrected the music of the past. He gave a summary of the music of the past, but also a heavy program for the music of the future, continuing the past. Did he create any new ragas, as Tyagaraja did? Do we come across for the first time some compositions of Dikshitar only through him in certain ragas? which were, so to say, the creations during that particular period of the 19th centuries. No. What ragas were likely to go into the oblivion, go into the background, go into decay, Dikshita resurrected. Such ragas like a Chaya Gaula, a Samanta, a Salanganata, these ragas could be traced to the medieval period of musical history and were almost dying. And Dikshita grasped, he grappled the situation. He was responsible, he was able to do it, he was responsible to do it because his background was a scholarly, musical scholarship had a tremendous background. His father was there, no less than the great Ramaswami Dikshita, the inventor of Hamsadhvani Raga. Shall we say inventor or creator? I think it's not correct. Because Hamsadhvani is a scale, one of the 225 Audava combinations, that is five-noted scales in both the Arohana and Avarohana. 225 combinations are there possible from each and every one of the 72 generic scales. And it struck to Ramaswami Dikshita to pick out. Ragas, scales form the legion and ragas are created out of them. So he picked up, it struck to him to pick up that beautiful scale of Hamsadhvani. And he made it, and he created life in it. That's the thing. So such was the Ramaswami Dikshita's genius. And he had learnt not only music but also the Sangeeta Shastra from one Muddu Venkatamakhyam. Muddu Venkatamakhyam. His real name was Venkata Vaidyanatha Dikshita. He comes in the descendancy of the great Venkatamakhi, Venkateshwara Dikshita, who wrote his Chaturdandi, Prakashika, in 1635 AD, and who formed the generic code. So that's all. So, Ramaswami Dikshita was the father of Vutuswami Dikshita. He had been initiated into holy Sri Vidya Diksha, Rajarajeshwari, Shodashakshara Mahamantra Diksha, etc., etc., by one Chidambaranatha Yogi. All of you know the biographical details. They are all readily available now through so many books. So I need not carry coals to Newcastle. So Muthuswami Dikshita had a very sound bringing. He was brought up on sound lines in both the literary aspect and also the musical aspect. He was a master of Sanskrit. He knew Telugu. And of course, he was a Vadadeshatta Vadamal. So, the Tamilian Brahmin. I will just take item by item and explain to you incidentally what Dikshita has done. What is Dikshita? One who posed the question, what sort of a man Dikshita was? He himself gave the answer. His compositions will tell him. So, I straight away plunge into the river. I don't look before leaping, but I simply leap. Now I start with a composition in Todi Raga, that Chauka Varna, that is called Chauka Varna. In some quarters, it is wrongly known as Padavarna. That is, of course, the difference between that. Why the Chauka Varna could be called Padavarna, or could it be called Padavarna at all? Those are things I am not going to discuss now. But to call it as Chauka Varna is correct and technically correct, because it is in a slow tempo, not in a medium tempo, but in a slow tempo. And I will just distinguish between them. Rupamujuchi in Todi Raga, Adi Tala,
In Sangeetism Pradaya Pradeshni, it has been given as the composition of Muddhaswami Dikshita. But, shall I say unfortunately, in some of the later publications it has been labeled as a composition of Subbarama Dikshita. Subbarama Dikshita was the adopted son of Baluswami Dikshita. Son of Baluswami Dikshita, Muddhaswami Dikshita's brother. This Subbarama Dikshita was a giant. He wrote the magnum opus, Sangeeta Sampradaya Pradarshani, which provides the authoritative lakshyas for the compositions of the Dikshita school. Not only the compositions of Muthuswami Dikshita, but also Ramaswami Dikshita, the compositions of the two brothers, Baluswami Dikshita, Chinnaswami Dikshita, etc. So, that Rupam Jyoti has been given as a composition of Muthuswami Dikshita, a Chauka Varna. Today that I have a Veena compliment, because Dikshita was a Vainika too. Veena Gana Dasa Gamaka Kriye, he refers in a composition which I will sing presently. And then Vainika Gayaka Guru Guha Nuta, for a Vaini Vinuta Gopikamanu. Some people say Bhaira Vinuta, because Ragamudra must come there. There must be that Raga, introduction of Ragamudra. It's not correct. The introduction of the Raga name, dexterous introduction of the Raga name in the midst of the texture of the composition. Of course, there's no doubt. It's invariably a feature of Dikshita Shrutis. But he has not done it as a matter of regular routine. In a number of compositions, we don't find the Ragamudra at all. I will sing certain compositions, one or two compositions where he does not introduce the Ragamudra, and some compositions where he introduces the Ragamudra and dexterously introduces the Ragamudra without offending the Sahitya. So Vainika Gayaka Guru Guna Tapura Vairi Vinuta. So that's correct reading of the text. So Vainika Gayaka. He comes first and then only myself. He did not say Gayaka Vainika. Though you are primarily a Gayaka, I envy. I am a little angry with Dikshita. No, not angry. But I appreciate because perfect vocal music is Veena. And perfect on the Veena is only vocal. Vocal must be like Veena and Veena must be like vocal. Vocal cannot be like violin. It is not possible to introduce it into to put attempt all sangaris which are produced on the violin. It may not be suitable for vocal. And vice versa. But Veena is not that. So, the appropriateness of having the Veena today, and that too on the day when I am exposing, giving a lecture on Dikshitar, the Veena accompaniment is most appropriate. And she is doing very well. I am very glad. Rupa mu jo jiva la jiva kele nero rupa mu jo jiva la jiva kele nero rupa mu jo Shanti Sundara Kara Mara Koti Sundara Kara Dara Gara Gara Dama Gara Gara Gama Gara Kogoti Dara Gara was predominantly a Chaukatala composer because the Veena helped him to achieve that. Now, this is Chaukavarna. Why it is called Chaukavarna? Because it is sung in Chaukakala. What is the marked difference between this and Tanavarna? You see, just I will explain it in one with reference to one line. Rupamu Bhava oriented. Ta ka di ni ake ta di mi. It goes like that. Ro wo 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 pa mo jo wo 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 che yi ba la che ma che ye te ye te ro wo 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 pa mo jo che yi ba la che ba de re ye 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 go go pa mo de ye 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 tu ra The same composition I have put it in the mold of the Tanavarna. That is the distribution of words. There is not that marked presentation of vowel extensions in between one letter one akshara of the sahitya, lyric, and the other akshara. But in the Tana Varna, there will be the profusion of vowel extensions between the contained in the preceding sahitya akshara, that is the thing. But here in the Chaukavarna, you see this one note of difference here.
Gavavagamadava.
The Mukta Isra, that is the Chitta Sara Passe, gives an apparent impression that it runs actually in Madhyamakala, that it is a, that goes in medium tempo.
Gavapa,
that is, takadimikita, what was takadimi? It now is apparently made clear.
Takadimikita dimi, gavapa gaya madapa, gapa magariza nidaniza. Regava dida dava va da pa da ga ma ga ma da da ni da ni da ni da re ga re ni da ma ga re sa re sa re ru.
That is the difference between the Tana Varna and this Chauka Varna. The physical format is the same. The sections, the other features like having charana, charana swaras, and some chaukavarnas may have sahitya for the chitta swara, that is mukta swara, and also the swara passages. Some chaukavarnas don't have. Ramaswami Dikshitar, Muthuswami Dikshitar, the father Ramaswami Dikshitar had composed one varna in Hindola, Vasanta Chaukavarna, which also does not have sahitya. Perhaps the son followed the father. He's also handed down to us through the Tanjung quartet descendants that Dikshitar just confined himself only to this one Chaukavarna, and he left it to the task. He left it to his disciple, Pannaya, Chinnaya, Shivanandam Vadivelu. Those were the direct disciples of Muthuswami Dikshitar. Seeing that inborn genius in these fellows to compose the Chaukavarna, their compositions were mainly intended, purposefully intended for the Bharatanatya concerts, because the Tanjung quartet, that Tanjavu, Pannaya, Chinnaya, Shivananda Madivilu, they were mainly responsible for drawing up the present physical format of the dance Bharatanatya concert. So Dikshitar realized that let us not worry about this job. Let us leave it to Pannaya. Let him compose as many Chaukavarnas as possible. So he repeated, that is why we are having only this one Varna, this Rupa Majuchi of Muthuswami Dikshitar. Now, Dikshitar has composed sets of Kritis. Sets of Kritis, that is, groups. They are called group Kritis, or they are called Samudaya Kritis. I do not know what Samudaya Kritis, that is a late, that technical term which came into existence after the 20s or 30s when Professor Samamurthy wrote his books. So, Dikshitar composed Kritis in praise of Lord Ganesha. 16 Kritis, showed as a Ganapati Kritis. And he composed group Kritis like on the planets, the seven planets, chief main planets, not on the Chaya Grahas, Rahu and Ketu. The compositions in Rahu and Ketu, Smaramiham and Sadara, Smaramiham and Maha, they are not the compositions of Dikshitar at all. Because the earliest collection of Dikshitars by Tachur Sikharachar, the brothers, brought out in the 70s or the 19th century, do not have these two compositions, and there are some prosodial errors also, and they deviate from the custodian style of Muthuswami Dikshitar, the tempo of Muthuswami Dikshitar. Those Kritis, two Kritis are in Chamaram and Rama Manohari. So I can boldly say they are not the compositions of Dikshitar. Some descendants should have composed in there, perhaps Subrahma Dikshitar himself or Ambi Dikshitar, the further descendant, and because they are, and either fortunately or unfortunately, they adopted the same signature as Guru Guha. Because Dikshitar adopted the signature Guru Guha because he got the blessings of Guha at the Tiruttani. The first composition he composed in Tiruttani is in Tamil Nadu. So, near Madras, just about 37, very near Madras. So, that's the thing. Dikshitar has composed like that, that Vara Kritis. And he has composed the Kritis, group Kritis, or a collection of sets of Kritis on the five elements, Prithvi, Appu, Teyu, Vayu, Akasha. And I will try to sing one from each group if time permits. And then he is the mighty Kamalamba Navavarna. Navavarna Kriti is mighty Kamalamba Navavarna. And then looking at the pattern and the physical format of the Navavarna Kritis, we have evolved our own other Navavarnas, which whether Dikshitar chose to call them as such or not, Abhyamba Navavarna. And so many Navavarna, Krishna Navavarna, Rama Navavarna, so many Navavarnas have been created because then the compositions of on these different deities. Dikshitar was a non-sectarian and he has a Catholicity of outlook of religion. So, though Guru Guha was the custodian deity for him, primary deity for him, still he has composed. His life was a long pilgrimage, offering of worship to each and every, and the deity, presiding deity of each and every shrine. Of course, the more about it, I will tell you as and when I sing the Kritis. Now, I will sing Shri Mahaganapati Ravatumam in Gaula. Why I have chosen that Kriti is because that is almost known to every one of you here. You are all very familiar with it. And then one thing, Dikshitar, Shri Mahaganapati Ravatumam is normally sung like this. Shri Maga Ganapati Ravatumam, Shri Maga Ganapati Ravatumam, Shri Devi Mahayako Mahatanga Bhagavi Maga Ganapati. This is how it is now being sung. The Chaputala was not, this is Chaputala now what I sang, how I executed the Tala. The Chaputala was not in rhyme with the Dikshitar's mode and mold. So he composed it only in Triputa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is known as Triputa, Triputa, three petals, three angas. There is one chatura, the Trishara Lagu, 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, one Dhrita, 6, 7, another Dhrita. One Trishara Lagu and two Dhritas. That is called Triputa Tala, one of the Suladi Sapta Talas. Incidentally, I may tell you, Dikshitar has composed in Suladi Sapta Talas and their varieties. He is the first to compose in all the Suladi Sapta Talas and their varieties. That is very important. Of course, the Suladi Sapta Tala has been adopted by Purandara Das also, the 15th, 16th centuries, and also Annamacharya. There is a Desi Suladi of Annamacharya and Suladi Sapta, adopting the Suladi Sapta Talas. So, Dikshitar has composed in all these Suladi Sapta Talas, and Shri Mahaganapati is in Triputa Tala, Trishra Jati Triputa Tala. If you say Triputa Tala, it means only, the presumption is only Trishra Jati Triputa. You need not say Trishra Triputa. Now, Shri Mahaganapati Ravatuma. This is the composition in praise of the Lord Ganesha on the tank, or the sacred tank of Tiruvarur, the birthplace of Dikshitar. The most coincidental, very happy coincidence of the three, this trinity, this musical trinity, Shyama Sastri, Chagrag and Dikshitar. All the three were born in Tiruvarur. That's the beauty about it. Kamalaye Kiraka Mukti, Kailil Yiraka Mukti. Jagraja was born in Tiruvarur and shook off his mortal coil in Tiruvayyar. So Kamalai Kaile, Bhuloka Kailasam, that is what is called Tiruvayyar. So that's the thing. But Dikshitar shook off his mortal coil in a Tayapuram where he had gone to attend his brother's wedding, Balaswami Dikshitar's wedding. And the story goes, he was there. And he asked his disciples to sing Meenakshi Memudam Devi, which he had composed in praise of Goddess Mejura on his way to Yatayapuram. He visited number of shrines and in Mejura he composed that Meenakshi Memudam Devi. And he asked that on the day of his demise, he was perfectly conscious of the moment when he will become one with the Jyoti. So he asked his disciples who had gathered there to sing that Meenakshi Memudam Devi. And when they sang Meenalochani, Pashamochani, he asked them to repeat it once or twice. And it is said that he shook off his mortal coil, hearing that Anupallavi, Meenalochani, Pashamochani, line occurring the Anupallavi Meenakshi Memudamdevi. Anyhow, that's all right. This is incidental to tell you that Dikshitar was a great traveler, the great pilgrim. So, the Shri Mahaganapati Ravatvam A composite in Gaula. A Gaula is an ancient raga, could be traced to the medieval period of musical history. Gaula, Gauda, varieties of Gauda, varieties of Gaula are all there in, mentioned in books. Chaya Gauda, Purva Gauda, Raya Gauda, Raya Gauda. One raga is met with in the Annamacharya top in copper plates. Raya Gauda. But we do not know how the form, melodic form is. That what that Raya Gauda. Annamacharya copper plates mentions is Raya Gauda. So this Gaula, that ancient raga. Normally accepted version of Arohana Varuna of Gaula is only Sarima Panisa, Sanipama Rigarisa. But I have taken lessons from Subbarama Dikshita. He gives the Arohana and Avarohana important murchanas of the raga, some concise murchanas of the raga he will put in. He will say murchana, Arohana, Avarohana. Murchana, and then you will put one big bracket, Arohana and Avarohana. So, once you sing the scale, that Arohana and Avarohana, the order of notes, the arrangement of the order of notes in the ascending order and the descending order respectively, gives the murchana, constitutes the murchana, that will constitute the pep of the raga, constitute the life and soul of the raga. So, instead of saying Sarima Panisa, Sanipama, Rigamarisa, you get Pamagamarisa. Pamagamarisa, Pamagamarigamarisa. So, Reza Riga Ma Rima Paniza. See, Sa Riga Ma Rima Paniza may not be accepted. So, Reza Riga Ma Rima Paniza. Sa Riga Ma Rima Paniza. Chagraja puts it in the, incorporates that phrase in the Duduku Gala, in the Charana. So, Reza Riga Ma Rima Paniza. Sa Nipa Ma Gama Rima. Solve some problem. Whether you can get Pamagama or Rigama, whatever it is. So, Riza Rigama Rima Paniza, Sani Pamagama Riza, Pamagama Riza, Pamagama Rigama Riza, Nini Pamagama Rigama Riza, 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 Mapani, mapani, mani, pani, dini, pani, 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 when it is not combined with the Shagya, it asserts its role. That is the Shri Maha Ganapati Ravatumam. Shri Maha Ganapati Ravatumam. Shri Devi Ayato Matanka Mukharati Ganapati Ravatumam. Definitely not Dikshitara Sangati. This Sangati is not, it does not belong to Dikshitara at all. It is our making. Shri Maha Ganapati Ravatumam.
ko mahatanga mara ke maya ganapati ka bhajana kavindra sannota ka bhajana kavindra ka sannota ka bhajana kavindra Sotaka majana kavidindra Sangota kamalalaya Tatati vaza kamajana kavidindra Sangota kamalalaya Tatati vaza Komalakara pallava palajuka guru guagraja
Composition of the pre-Trinity period. Yet
opposite to the pre-Trinity period, much a prelude, a great action, as I always used to say. The great action has been set up by the composers of the pre-Trinity period. The three fellows were in an advantageous position. Tyagara, Shyama Sastri, Tyagaraja and Krishna. They were in a very advantageous position. Much had been prepared. Some menu had been prepared. They prepared these dishes. So that's it, like Natakaranji. I will not omit that phrase. I love that phrase. That is the phrase played by Krishna Pillai, Malakottai Govind Sampillai and Papa Vangata Ramayya on the violin. The panchana must be put to an absolute minimum in Natakaranji. Mani dani padani sa, just to honor the tradition, historical tradition, textual tradition, because the Natakaranji has been paraphrased in Shaji Maharaja's 100 ragas of Shaji Maharaja, a manuscript which was taken as the basis by King Tulajaja the First, who wrote his Sangeeta Saramrita in 1735. So there you find Panchama. So to honor the textual tradition, we have to insert that inclusion of Panchama should not be intrusion. Nida 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 maga 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 maga. The reverse was known as Jampatala, the classical 108 talas for the tala. 108 talas mentioned in Bharata's Natyashastra and other works which you follow. So, Jampatala, one of the Sola, the Sapta talas, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, that is the Buddha Graha, a Kriti attached to them. And now, you know how Diksha has started it? Buddhatma Shraya Abhi Sattva. But I contacted Dikshitar. In my concentration, in my contemplation, in my understanding of the raga, Natakuranji, I just contacted him. Will you kindly permit me to introduce this Sangati as the fourth, order? So that I sing like this.
Buddhavma Shrayami Satatho Suravidnota Chandrata Buddhavma Shrayami Satatho Suravidnota
I introduce it a little leisurely.
Buddhava raya ami tathahum surabhinota chandrata rasukabhu dhamma raya ami tathahum Surabhinota chandrata rasutabhu dhamma sayami satatam Surabhinota chandrata rasutabhu dhamma sayami
What was the first for Dikshitar, I made it the last. So that I am satisfied that Panchama has been given its due role. That is Langhanatva, not that Anabhyasa of the Panchama will highlight Natakuranji. Because Sarigamada Nisada Nida Bhagasa. But for textual purposes, for honoring the traditional setup, the Panchama is introduced. So I felt like that. Of course, I took his permission. He said, oh, go on. Madhura Kavita Pratham. One who was the Buddha planet, Buddha Graham, Nala Gatti Da Yirkarvanaki, you will be a scholar. Buddha, Buddhi, Buddha.
Madhura Kavita Pratham, Umagani Azob, Buddha Vada.
Perhaps he does not go well. That is why he is always one for whom the Buddha is very strong, they will be Buddhimantula Namata.
Kalyadi Pahu Bhutaka Karnau Napu
Napu Sagam, he is duty taker.
King Karajana Magito, Kilbishadi Ragito, Shankarabhagito, Sandhanda Sagito, Buddha Maharaya Bhiti, Sata, 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 Udava Chaya Ami Sata Toho.
Now I will go to the Kamalamba Navavarma. The Kamalamba Navavarma is a scheme like this. It has a jhana kriti. And then set of kritis in the different orders of vibhakti, case endings. First case, second case, nominative case, and then instrumental case, accusative case, genitive case, and then ablative case, and vocative case. And then he concludes it with a mangala, so that usually there will be some 11 kirtanas. So, Dhyana Kriti will be the first and the Mangala Kriti will be the last, and in between the Kritis are there set in order. And this Kamalamba Navavarna is composed in praise of the goddess Kamalamba, his birthplace Tiruvaru. Now I will sing that Kamalamba Samrakshata, because why I have taken that, that is the first, that is Dhyana Kriti is in Todi. I will sing another kriti in Todi, and this dhyana kriti, leaving that, the first kriti, that is in the nominative case, that is a Kamalamba Samrakshatu, Kamalamba Samrakshatu, that's it. Then second kriti is Kamalambam Bajare, instrumental case, and then the third kriti is in Shakrabrana, and goes on by Ravi Sahana Ayu. Oh, is a mighty color, mighty group, mighty group, I can say. Musical maturity there. At its highest peak, zenith of perfection, you find it, and not only that, unbounded scholarship of Dikshitar in literature and these ancient, what you call, smritis. He has read a lot. He was a custodian of an high power of high potential of potency of knowledge of sacred law. That's it. So this Kamalamba Samrakshita, I have taken it because that presents a beautiful Ananda Bhairavi, and Ananda Bhairavi highlighting the Shuddha Daivata, the Komala Daivata, to a large extent. And that is also in Triputa Tala.
Kamalaya Bhaja Samrakshita Rata Tumala Kamalaya Bhaja.
You cannot take law into hands. It cannot be so casual. It cannot be so casual. That is not in Chaputala at all. There is no Chaputala to be found in Dikshita Smriti at all. I can write, I can give a stamp statement. You can take it to any court of law. Takita taka. This is only the Triputa Tala that is a patent, because that was suitable for his style. That's a slow tempo. Nidana prakriti, nidana. Kavadla dava, kavadla, that is wrong. Kavadla, because how is Ananda Bhairavi handled now? That should not be the criterion. That should not be the case when you sing this particular kriti of Dikshita. In Manasa Guru Guha Rupa Majarena Ananda Bhairavi kriti, that is second kriti of Dikshita composed in Tirutani. The first was Sri Nathadi Guru Guha Jayati Jayati. The second was Manasa Guru Guha Rupam Bhajare. That is a second vibhakti. That kriti, that Manasa Guru Guha Rupam presents the setup of Ananda Bhairavi, which is very, 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 very familiar. Perhaps it was substantiated by Shama Sastri, which was the patent property, perhaps, of Shama Sastri. But in this kriti, Dikshita wanted to preserve, resurrect the past, how Ananda Bhairavi was there, how the Shuddha Daivata was the guiding factor. The Chatushuddhi Daivata, Nidanisa, one phrase, Nidanisa, it's only in that particular phrase that occurs in as the last avarta of the Madhyamakala Sahitya in the Charana. There alone, the Chatushuddhi, clear-cut Chatushuddhi Daivata, the Tivara Daivata is used. And not only that, Nidanisa phrase. We are thinking that Ananda Bhairavi takes only Padapasa. Where is Padapasa and where is Nidanisa? What a daring incorporation of that phrase, because that was old phrase, archaic phrase, Arsha Prayoga, that was almost gone, going into the oblivion, which Dikshita took care. He called a halt to the things, such things, oh, it should not happen. Let it go, let the tradition be preserved and transmitted to posterity. So,
Kamala Bhaga Samraksha Tumala Kamala Bhaga Samraksha Tumala
which all of you are familiar now.
So, Kamala Janam Dabo Dazuki Kantatara Panjar Suki Kamala Janam Dabo.
the modern trends is perhaps we are thinking that we are going into inroads to rethink our life. That's wrong. We think so many things wrongly. Then Charana.
Tripura Adhikshaya Eshwari Hani Madhe Siddhi Shwari Yidni Jakha Ameshwari Kshiti Pura Trai Loga Jaya Mogata Chakra Kravat.
Why do you make that? Why do you bring that modernity there?
Kshiti Pura Trai Loga Jaya Mogata Chakra Vatini Ye Prakata Yoga Vagini Suraripu Magi Shansura Adi Mardi Nigama Pura Adi Soho Vedi Tripureshi Buru Bhuga Janani.
This is definitely Madhyamakala Sahitya. Ta ki ta ta ka dimmi now. Ata ki ta ta ka dimmi ki ta 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 ka dimmi. Ata ki ta ta ka dimmi. Ata ki ta ta ka dimmi. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is bold in the Pallavi Anupallavi. And up to this point now. Ata ki ta ta ka dimmi. Ata ki ta ta ka dimmi. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Tripureshi Guru Bhoga Janani Tripura Bhangjani Ranjani
Nidanisa. I tell you, the Nidanisa was there. Don't forget.
Tripureshi Guru Bhoga Janani Tripura Bhangjani Ranjani Madhuri Pura Bhangjani Pura Sondari Pura.
That was the close Ananda Bhairava Dikshita.
Madhasa Guru Goha.
You see the Rupa Gatala I am now doing not.
Madhasa Guru Goha.
I am not doing like that. That is Rupa Gatala. As I have been always telling in every one of my lectures, when I deal with Rupa Gatala, of course.
Madhasa Guru Govardhu Pao Bhajare Re Maha Yamaya Re Kaapo Jajare Ye Manava Jam
with vengeance, Chatushruti Devata. And the Kriti, that Kriti where he had avoided Chatushruti Devata and had made it Shuddha Devata dominating. He has brought that Chatushruti Devata. So he has studied the Raga Lakshana perfectly well.
Paramatma Nirati Shayasuka Yajare Mahanasa.
You see, like Kamalambana, you didn't get that Raga Mudra Ananda Bhairavi. Here in this Manasa Guru Rupam Bajare, he has introduced Ananda Bhairavam in the Charana. But in the Kamalampa, because it was a Kriti under a scheme, so he did not feel the necessity of introducing the Ragamudra Ananda Bhairavi. Why in Dakshinamurta you don't get the Shankaravarna at all? Sri Subramanyanam says you don't get the name Kambhoji at all. Only in Kashi Vishveshwara you get Kambhoja. Kambhoja Kara Vibho. Now, that incidentally takes me to this. The treatment of raga, the treatment of one and the same raga in different kritis. Indifferent kritis. See, there are two modes of taking the raga. That is, the raga could be taken from the lower region, Purvanga Pradhanatva. That is, what a mighty raga, Kambhoji, the Kambhoji of the ancient Tamils. This raga was used to worship goddess Shakti. As I told in some of my lectures, the convention lecture, rightly Tyagaraja chose this Kambhoji to extol the greatness of Sita, was all Shakti incarnate. Is it Shankaravarna?
No.
Nishada is not there, Devita is there. How can you say it is not Shankaravarna, sir? No, I will say it is not Shankaravarna, it is only Kambhoji. Listen. Not myself, the raga says. The raga says, no, I am only Kambhoji. Taking the raga like this from the notes of the lower region. Then going to Panchama. It need not depend upon the lyric to move you, the words which carry some emotions to move you, even the combinations of sounds, phrases, that's enough. The tender lover, how handling the love, not molesting his love. Na 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 Daivata is there. Na 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 na. It is Daivata or Nishada. It is barking.
Da da ra da 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 da.
That was the life of Mijaramani's music. Da re 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 re. This is one mold of taking raga. The Nagaswaram performers of the Tanju school, they straightway took the raga to the top because it was Puramura, Ahamura, Puramura, open door music, not chamber music like this. The deity was there, kept in the procession, coming in the procession. It was kept in a particular place for some considerable time, so that all the people from the surrounding villages will throng there, will assemble there to have the darshan of the deity, so that the Nagaswaram performer was incidentally given an opportunity to deal the raga at length. He will slowly take up the raga, move the raga, weave the raga slowly, but go to the top there, he will deal with the kamboji there. So, these are the two accepted methods of dealing of that, rendering the raga alapana. And Dikshita has done, followed one thing in the Sri Subramanya Namaste, the other thing in Kashi Vishveshwara. He has composition, both are Kamboji, in Kamboji, one in Rupa Katala. And the another composition, Kashi Vishveshwara and Kamboji in Kanta Jati Atatala. Just now I told you, Dikshita has composed in all the Sula, the Sapta Talas, seven principal Talas, traditional Talas. See,
Shri Subramanya Namaste.
Yadirka Sashtanga Namaskar.
Shri Subramanya Namaste. Namaste.
Done by the great Mahavajjanaka. That's the thing. Now, this is the mode of taking composition this way. Then goes to the sequence or the progression of the Dhatu
having a perfect bearing with one section and the other. Because the charana uses some total effect. Just the paragraphs, what has been dealt with already is summed up and presented and projected and highlighted to the chief authorities, their superiors, to grant what is solicited, what is requested in this letter. An official letter. The raga alapana could easily be compared to an official letter. There is a subject, reference, and introductory paragraphs paving the ground for what he asked, what you asked, and justification of what you ask, etc. And then the concluding paragraphs, under the circumstances cited such and such, this is the father and the papa pointed out, not the your esteemed, all that, what you call. And then these following points could kindly be taken into consideration. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that is sort. Now, the Kasi Visveshwara, composed in praise of Lord Vishwanatha, presiding deity of one Kulikarai. Kulikarai or Kulikarai. It is near Thiruvarur in Tanjore district. Kaji. Shooting straight to the top. Kaji. Vishveshwara yehi mampa yehi kalasi vishveshwara yehi
clear marked cotton shraddha is there in this Smriti. That is a, what is the authority? Subbarama Dikshitar's Sangeet Sampradaya Pradashni, that Sanini is there, given in that quotation. Then, Kashi Kshetra Sadri Sadi Kalpa
Kshetra's name is